So nature's Ozempic is really a supplement that's a fraction of the cost of Ozempic and Wegovy that acts similarly for weight loss, diabetes management, for insulin resistance, for hypertension. Those are all the things killing America and the rest of the world as the Western diet propagates it. And I'll dive into a head-to-head comparison as to what you can expect from this natural supplement versus Big Pharma's drug. And there's a head-to-head study with metformin. At the end, I'll go through that with you. And I know many of you are on metformin, you've heard about it, or you're considering it for longevity. Does it make you live longer? We're diving into everything today. Let's get started. So berberine is a relatively new addition to the supplement world, but no doubt you've heard about it on social media. From my last poll, you guys said per day, you're on it about 4 to 6 hours, maybe more. It's trending all over social media. Now you all know about Ozempic and Wegovy, the story of the weight loss diabetes drug and how it took over Hollywood and how Hollywood is quote unquote stealing it, the life-saving drug for their weight loss. And it's true. Almost everyone I know is on it. Even thin people are taking it. I think there's a little longevity story here that people are believing into, and it does have many hormone-like effects. The buzz all about berberine really relates to its utility as a natural aid for people with type 2 diabetes, high cholesterol, and high blood pressure. There's even literature that suggests it can strengthen the heartbeat. Now that changes its purpose because people with congestive heart failure or arrhythmias are now interested in this. And that's why it's really taken the internet by storm. Now it all sounds too good to be true. And you're wondering, why are you hearing about it just now? Well, it actually has a long history of medicinal use and it's found naturally in plants. Thus, it's been used for centuries in, of course, traditional Chinese medicine. You probably guessed it. But how does it stack up to Wegovy and Ozempic? Well, Wegovy and Ozempic work by their active ingredient, semaglutide or semaglutide. It works by inducing satiety. It has many hormone-like effects, but the feeling of being satisfied or full suppresses appetite. That's one main pathway. That's why it works for weight loss. Now, before we compare the results of this to berberine, let's look at what berberine actually is so this all makes sense to you. It's an alkaloid found in the roots, leaves, and stems of plants such as barberry, Oregon grape, and tree turmeric. You can get it through these plants, but because they're uncommon in the United States, that's why supplementation is much more commonly used. Here are the main uses. Number one, to help with diabetes, lowering blood sugar. Number two, actually, we talked about lipids. Well, it lowers the bad one, or the LDL, and the cholesterol and triglycerides. Number three, reducing blood pressure. Number four, it can help actually with canker sores. And number five, polycystic ovaries. So there's a wide range of use. We're, of course, interested in the first three. Now, Ozempic helps with weight loss, and that's why many of you are here watching this. But what about berberine? One past study found that when people with obesity were given, now 500 milligrams was the dose here, 3 times a day for 12 weeks, so 3 months, they did lose weight. But how much? How much compared to Ozempic and Wegovy? Well, about 5 pounds. That was the average. Think 3%. So if you extrapolate the data from the study, 3% of weight of the body was lost. So 100 pounds, if you weigh 100 pounds, well, you're probably not on it for that reason, but you'd lose 3 pounds. 200 pounds, you'd lose about 6 pounds. But they also noticed in that study a decrease in triglycerides. So like we said, there's many beneficial effects. And keep in mind that at that rate of weight loss, you're not going to have the side effects typically you get with Ozempic. What am I mean? Hair loss, telogen effluvium that I covered in another video, and Ozempic face, the changes of the face. And I'll tell you, from seeing so many people on Ozempic at all the conferences I go to, people look different. So it's not just weight loss. It could be bone loss that I'm seeing with the weight loss, but they look different to where you walk by them and you're like, whoa, who is that? And then they talk, you recognize the voice. So there is something about Ozempic face that's a little bit different. And I can't say you're not going to see that with berberine, but I think the rapid weight loss that we see causing the hair problem is probably what we're seeing in the face. Kind of an unhealthy look, I must say. Let's dive into the Ozempic-like effects that so many people here are wondering about. Research has shown that berberine decreases hemoglobin A1C, and that's a measure of your average blood sugar over the past 3 months. A review of research published in April 2021 in the journal Frontiers in Pharmacology noted that berberine improves insulin resistance in people with type 2 diabetes. Those are the ones they looked at particularly. So they did have a disease process. Another study in 2020 in the journal of Nature Communications found probiotic and berberine, so they gave people both, taken together, significantly impacted study participants' hemoglobin A1C levels compared to the group who only took the probiotic. Now, it's not just blood pressure, but also the regularity of the heartbeat, or people with an irregular heartbeat and heart failure. A review published in September 2021 in the American Journal of Chinese Medicine found that it has beneficial effects for heart disease by helping to combat inflammation and oxidative stress, as well as by assisting regulation of electrical signals and ionic channels in the body. So it's pretty amazing. And of course, the electrical system in the heart is very unique to the heart in that you don't think about it. The heart just beats on its own, but arrhythmias are common and they lead to a lot of problems because people have to go on blood thinners for them. They can be troubling and people often feel them pounding in their heart and they are sporadic. So you never know when they might come on and off. So there is data to look at that. If you weren't going to watch this video, you now know exactly why you need to look. This is what the experts tell you on a study drug for millions and millions of dollars. There's not that much data on berberine, they say. The claims are pretty overstated when it comes to the impact on weight loss based on the evidence and the literature that's available. Now let's really look at that. They actually say here, look, the hype surrounding the supplement, isn't that surprising? Look at this. The obesity drugs, the ones that they say are studied, cost as much as $1,300 per package, meaning per month, and Ozempic is approved. Those with type 2 diabetes can cost more than $1,000 per month. At least they realize that's a steep price. But moreover, let's look at the actual study. If we look at the study drug in this expensive trial, the efficacy of semaglutide found adults with obesity took the drug for, look at this, 68 weeks, lost 15% of their body weight. But look, in combination with lifestyle changes. So imagine that. The millions and millions and billions of dollars they spent studying the drug for 68 weeks duration of this drug that we don't know the long-term side effects of, reduce body weight by 15%, but not just the drug alone, but with lifestyle changes. Let's really dive into berberine, the natural nature's choice. Pretty nefarious from the drug companies, if you ask me. Here again, another review of research published in May 2020 in the Journal of Clinical Nutrition found that berberine supplement had a positive impact on body weight, body mass index, which is calculated by using your weight and your height together, and waist circumference. Often these studies do look at waist circumference because that's an indication of truncal obesity. Now, Ozempic and Wegovy, which were found by accident. So Ozempic came out for diabetes. They looked at it, they found, hey, we're seeing weight loss with this. So Big Pharma, what do? Up the dose, change the name, call it Wegovy, and they come out with it. So that's why there's Ozempic and Wegovy, and I use them interchangeably, same company, but they Wegovy in effect was found by accident because when diabetics were taking the Ozempic, they found, hey, people are losing weight. We can capitalize on the weight loss market. Let's come out up with Wegovy. And that is in fact what we're seeing happening with berberine now. People are increasing the dose from that aforementioned dose I'm talking about. But remember, you need to be safe about it. There's no real safety data on those higher doses of berberine. And what we have on the regular dosing that I mentioned is limited data. I'll go through some of that in a moment because it is fascinating how there are parallels with Wegovy and Ozempic. Let's not forget Fenfen, the weight loss drug from, was it the mid-90s or so? But that caused a lot of heart problems. There were a lot of lawsuits over that, but many people took Fenfen. I certainly feared the same thing might happen with Ozempic and Wegovy. Certainly this is your all-natural alternative, but we still need to see better safety data on those higher doses people are using. Now, how much do you take? We're going to talk a little bit more about dose in the studies, but typically you're thinking about 0.4, so 0.4 to 1.5 grams. That's kind of the range of dosing, but I'll dive into that a little more specifically in a moment. Now it gets better. You see, one of the side effects of berberine is, guess what? Upset stomach, diarrhea, constipation, gas. Sound familiar? Yes, just like Ozempic and Wegovy. And that's why people take them on typically Friday. Ozempic and Wegovy are shots you put in the abdomen, boom, once a week. And people take it like Thursday or Friday, and then they take the weekend off because they know they're not going to feel well. Some people who take berberine have those same side effects because it works similarly using the same, some of the same receptors at least. So we'll get into metformin, and I'm going to compare them further, but now at least you have an indication of why this took social media and TikTok by storm. You have a natural alternative that has so many similarities to the big pharma Ozempic that people can't even get, and diabetics can't get, because people have run out of Wegovy, so they go over and get their Ozempic, which the diabetics are waiting for. Now let's look at that head-to-head study with metformin. Somewhat fascinating. Effects of berberine on type 2 diabetes mellitus was first reported in 1986. Yin et al. Compared the effects of berberine with metformin. Now a lot of people take metformin also for anti-aging. Keep that in mind. In a three-month trial, 36 patients, relatively small number, but 3 months, with type 2 diabetes mellitus were randomly assigned with berberine or metformin. It was found that hypoglycemic effect of berberine, look at this, is comparable to that of metformin. The level of hemoglobin A1C fasting and postprandial, that means after eating glucose, decreased by 7.5% and 6.9% and 11.1% respectively at the end of the trial. Similar findings were reported in a clinical study of Zhang et al. And then a meta-analysis of 21 clinical trials. Now that's a lot. We don't know the nature exactly of those trials. Were they double-blind, placebo-controlled, randomized prospective animal trials? We don't know. That seems like a lot for this product. Revealed that berberine has a therapeutic effect on type 2 diabetes, hyperlipidemia, hypertension, comparable to other therapeutic regimens. Studies have indicated that similarly to metformin, berberine executes functions by regulating a variety of effectors. So by these pathways, to be noteworthy, the activation of AMPK, berberine can stimulate glucose uptake. Listen to this. This is important. Glucose uptake, muscle, liver, adipose, which is fat, and inhibit gluconeogenesis, so the formation of sugar in the liver by downregulation of gluconeogenic enzymes. So the pathways, some of the pathways they share are similar to the drugs we pay a lot of money for, and it has a positive effect on many things. But I know you guys are particularly interested in metformin because many people take it for longevity and for extension of life. That will be likely the next thing you're going to see blow up on TikTok with the likes of these trials.
Now, how does it come? Well, capsules are the most bioavailable, but it does come in a gel. Most commonly, the gel is used for the canker sores, the antiviral activity that it has. But supplements, you're going to see it mainly in capsule form. Now, one of the most important parts of this channel is that we share information. So I want you to talk below in the comments. What are you taking? How much are you taking? Have you heard of it? And if you're getting side effects, it helps everyone learn. And I found out only 60% of you are subscribed to this channel. If you're getting value, please subscribe. You're going to want to watch this video on the popular supplement magnesium. It helps so many people, but you want to know exactly what form of magnesium to take. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.